hurry up. Pass me the phone. Come on, come on, come on.
Oh my God, hi, Carrie. You're coming out, beauty.
And it's I'm Monique Nicole. And you already know DJ the rapper.
Go ahead, Carrie. Go ahead, Carrie. Go ahead, Carrie. Tell it like it is, boy. Go ahead, Carrie. Go ahead, Carrie. Go ahead, Carrie. Tell it like it is, boy. Go ahead, Carrie. Go ahead, Carrie. Go ahead, Carrie. Tell it like it is, boy. Go ahead, Carrie. Go ahead, Carrie. Go ahead, Carrie. Tell it like it is, boy.
Tell it like it is, do your radio. Fully syndicated, funny for the silly folks. Always keep it positive, never negative. Carrie's Corner is the name. Welcome to the show. High-top celebrities bringing in the voice of the community. It ain't gonna stop. And when he start to play the beats, I'ma have to write you up a eulogy, cause they so hot. And I stay live, and I stay woke when the man trying to keep me on demand.
Hey, what's going on, y'all? It's your boy, Kerry D. Singleton. This is the Kerry's Corner Radio Show. We are here in, it's not mid-January. I'm wishful. Because I don't like winter. Can't wait till it's over. And then we have spring where I can sneeze every day for no reason. But anyway, enough of my gripes about the seasons. It is what it is. I'm just happy to be alive. Happy to be in the studio with the team, the dopest team on the air. Mr. Paul Dorsa, Mr. Kevon Merrill, and of course, Mr. Andre Jones. Yes, shout out to Mr. Cox. He's not in. He's sick or something. I don't know what's going on with his brother. He's in the hospital. What's going on? Does anybody know? I know he has something going on, a doctor's appointment or something. I don't know. But shout out to Mr. Cox. Gordon's late. Guess that plane from Yonkers.
Oh, I know that's got to hurt.
Yeah.
I'm sure he on his way, though, so that's a good thing.
Yeah, well... Yeah. Anyway, yeah. Shout out the whole crew. Those that are here, those that are near, and those that are dear. How about that? Anyway, I had a great time on Sunday. What day was that? The 8th, Kevon?
Yes.
The 8th?
Yep, the 8th.
January 8th. We attended, he being Kevon, myself, and Dwayne Butler from Intrigue Magazine all attended the High Five Up Close and a very personal show at City Winery NYC. Shout out to Chris, aka Skip, their road manager, who made sure that we were tended to properly. We got to hang out with the guys, high five backstage after their dress rehearsal.
Rehearsal. That was awesome. Very cool. Very personal going backstage.
Yeah, backstage, laid back. But they're good friends of mine. You know, good guys. They're definitely friends of the show. And we got to, you know, kick it with them. And, you know, basically, Kevon recorded a impromptu chill-out section. It wasn't even an interview.
That's, right,
you know,
not an interview.
We wanted to do, like, a chill-out section with High Five. And God only knows what we talked about. Because we, again, it was like the camera wasn't even on us. And so,
yeah, y'all were just talking. Like,
yeah.
It went off to all sorts of topics.
Yeah. Shout out to Farouk. He's lost a lot of weight. He's doing a lot of gym work.
Yeah,
and
he
so
looks
he's,
awesome.
He's taking off a lot of clothes lately. I remember mentioning that. I was like, you're taking off a lot of clothes. Like, with each push-up, another layer of clothes is coming off, brother. And he said something to the effect of, well, I don't work for this for nothing or something. And I was like, yeah, I respect it. I mean, I guess the shirts are getting tighter.
But you would do the same, though.
I definitely would. I would be. Yeah, I'm thinking of thongs. I'm thinking of, you know, for me, I'm saying, for me. Like, if the body was where I want it to be, a thong, Coney Island, just once, maybe. Yeah, thong.
You can't make this up, ladies and gentlemen.
I could fill it up, though. Anyway, shout out to High Five, Tristan, Marcus, Shannon, Farouk, and Billy. Shout out to those guys. They've been doing a lot of work lately. They got a couple of events coming up. I know that they just flew out this morning because they were going to come to the show today, but they had to go. Shout out to Peter Wayne. Am I pronouncing his name right, Kevon?
I think that's right, Peter Wayne.
Peter Wayne.
Not the other one.
Yeah, not okay. Peter Wayne. Shout out to that brother. That brother can sing.
He can sing.
He's a good dude.
A room.
And he opened up the show at the City Winery with High Five. Also, shout out to Dawn Michelle. Shout out to my brother from another mother, Bobby Simmons. Bobby Simmons from Steps to Sonic. I almost messed that one up because it's a tongue twister. He was ill for much of last summer, so we're just happy that he's doing better. Again, Bobby Simmons, shout out to you. It was great to see you. Shout out to Violators. The Violators team was in the building. And shout out to, of course, Intrigue Magazine. Now, I will say this, and you knew this was coming, right, Kevon?
Oh, man. Oh, no.
We were seated. We had premier seating. They let us sit wherever we wanted in the venue.
Very true.
And so Dwayne decided he wanted to sit way in the back, which I can never understand that. I mean, we didn't want to sit in the front. But why do we have to sit like 1,000 miles away from the stage when we're VIPs?
Angle.
I don't know. That just doesn't make any sense for me. But I will say this. The Food of City Winery, I had fries. And, I mean, they weren't remarkable. Kevon, what did you have? You had the...
I had a burger and fries. You classic had a burger.
Classic burger.
Yeah.
And Dwayne had the fake burger.
The impossible
burger.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, the service was... shout out to our server. She gave us some nice glasses for water. You know, and I don't drink tap water, so I didn't. But I did part... I figured, you know what? As much as I paid for that damn meal and as much as I tipped her, I felt entitled to taking two of the glasses that were on the table.
Yeah.
And I did it, before you all judge, I did it in memory of Kevon's Nana.
He certainly said that when he did, but yeah, that is.
Do you want to tell the story, Kevon, or no?
Right. So, yeah, that's a thing that my Nana would do. She was very famous for when she saw something pretty in a restaurant or something, if she saw something she liked, that would go straight into her purse. No questions asked, no debate. Nobody had to know. Nobody would ever know.
Just right in the purse, right?
Right in the purse.
Right.
No.
So what is the most memorable thing that you remember either going into your Nana's purse or coming out of your Nana's purse?
Right, yeah. I told Carrie about this. So this was something that I remember my Nana taking out of her purse. We were at a restaurant where no doubt she was thinking about what pretty things on the table she could put into her purse. But since we were waiting for so long, it took them forever to get us seated.
Like,
Nana got hungry,
right.
And so she... Like Batman, I guess, pulled out a hot dog out of her purse,
fully
wrapped in aluminum foil, ready to, like, she got it from the cart before we came and was ready, knowing.
Wow. I meant to ask you when you told me that story yesterday, was the hot dog in a bun with, like, the toppings?
No, it was ready to go. It was like, you picked it up from the cart, your little classic dirty water dog, as my family calls it, and... There you go.
Ready And she ate it right there at the table.
Yep. Before we got seated even.
No.
Yeah.
So did anybody in your family, your mom, did anybody say anything?
My mom has no patience. She was just like, what are you doing? Where did you get that? She was just confused. Like, where did you get that? Why did you have it?
What was it doing there?
Yeah, exactly.
Wow.
No answer required.
And you remember that moment.
Stuck in my head forever.
So see, that's what you told me that story, and you told me about your Nana and how she, you know, she liked pretty things. And I thought, you know what? As much as this meal costs and as long as they're taking to give us our food, I should. The glasses were really nice.
They were pretty.
They were pretty. Like, and I like, you know, nice things. So I put it in my bag, both of them. Matching sets.
Self-snitching.
Yeah, well, hey, whatever. Shout out to Coach D of Code 31 TV Podcast. She's, of course, a friend of the Kerry's Corner Radio Show. I'm going to be a guest on Wednesday at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, so check that out. Can't wait. Congratulations to her on her new podcast TV show. I checked out a new restaurant with our guest today, Aziz, last week. Yemen Cafe on Atlantic Avenue in Brooklyn. Very good food. Delicioso food. And, not very bad prices for the food that you got too. So definitely shout out to the Yemen Cafe on Atlantic Avenue in Brooklyn. You guys, the new issue of Intrigue Magazine, the December 2022, January 2023 issue is out, featuring articles on Vivian Greene's holiday single. Go to IntrigueMagazine.com for that. Also, the latest issue of Photography Insight Plus magazine is also out, featuring stories with designer Sierra Penny, the 6th Annual Sitter Awards, Infinite Exposure Awards, and MadCloud.com is where you go for that. Make sure you guys subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click on the bell for notifications on your posts, on our new posts, I'm sorry. And now we're going to just get into the Kerry's Conversations topic, which we're reverting back to Paul's list. Paul had a pretty robust list prior to the holidays, but I shied away from them just because I wanted to have holiday-themed questions. But since the holidays are finally officially over, we'll start with you, Kevon, being that you're the excuse me, youngest. And I'm curious to know if you have an answer that of a person who I even know exists.
Right.
Who was a famous person that you have met before?
Yeah, so mine is probably going to be a little unconventional because I don't think my person is famous. Okay. But I believe they should be famous.
Well, famous is relative, let's say. Because a lot of people from the young generation, these little people, young.
Right, littles and youngs.
And the babies, like they're famous to you. I don't know who they are. Like, quite frankly, I don't even know who this football player is that had this accident recently. Right. I have no idea. I never heard of him. Yeah. I just know that the Buffalo Bills are going to win the Super Bowl as a result of his injury. I'm sorry. I'm just going to say it.
Oh, it's not just that. That means, you know what? I'll save my Chris Rock
joke
for later.
Yeah, please. Don't. Very sensitive topic, Dre, to most people, just because I don't know who the gentleman is.
Oh, no. I hope he does well, but
there's
I also hope the Bills win for a good reason.
Okay, well, I'm sure that they will. Because I remember when 9/11 happened, the Yankees won. Not that they shouldn't, but I know how it goes. Anyway, keep on.
Yes, so the individual that I met is a paleontologist who's very well known within that sphere, called Dr. Kenneth Lacavara.
Wow.
And I was very impressed to meet him. I've met him on two different occasions, and once when I was at a conference for science-interested people, and another time when I worked at Liberty Science Center.
Okay.
He was promoting his book, Why Dinosaurs Matter. Awesome guy, great paleontologist, and I embarrassed myself a little last time I met him, but hope I can meet him again.
How did that happen?
I brought up some stuff that I saw on his blog as if I knew him.
that's pretty dope. I mean, it's okay to fan out. I've done it. Believe me. And again, it's about a circle. Bobby Fischer, I bet you nobody in the room knows who Bobby Fischer is, right? Gordon, you know who Bobby Fischer is, right? Okay. If you're into chess, Bobby Fischer
is the premier
chess person. So he would be, if you're into chess, then you would find him. So again, it's about, you know, who your circle. So that's pretty dope. Paul, I don't want to hear anything about you didn't know about the question or any of that other stuff.
What question?
The question is, who is a famous person you have met before?
Oh, it's my turn?
Yes, it is.
I've actually met a lot of famous people.
Just pick one.
I don't even know. I'll go with a Giant player I've met, Michael Strahan.
Okay.
So
the New York Giants.
Yeah, shout out to the Giants. Okay. I disagree with what you were saying before about the Bills winning the Super Bowl. The Giants are going to win it all this year. I got faith in the
team. Okay, I mean, I'm not saying, well, for political reasons, I feel like Bills. Yeah.
No, I know what you're saying. I'm just saying, G-Men all the way, baby.
Okay.
Let's go.
Okay. Shout out to the New York Giants. Andre Jones, I'm always afraid to ask you a question, thinking I'm going to always thinking there's a good chance that I'm going to get canned from our syndicated networks.
Listen,
a famous
if I didn't get
person
canned for some of those things I've said that's been recorded, I think we're good.
So. Yeah, well, there's always time. Who is a famous person you have met before?
You know, I'll go with something a little more recent.
Okay.
DJ Fat Fingers.
Okay.
He is international known, played on Hot 97 and 105.
Okay.
And various different networks as a session DJ. He also worked on the Wendy Williams show.
Oh, okay. Shout out to him.
I met him a couple of times. And I've talked to him, down to earth, really cool.
Okay.
I mean, I've met other famous people, but him recently, and it sticks out the most because he's a DJ that's been in the field when, you know, you had to actually have skills or they told you, get, oh, yeah, no.
Okay. All right. Anybody want to take a guess at what my answer is going to be? Yeah. Anybody? Kevon?
The time that you met Janet Jackson?
Yes. 1997, Virgin Megastore, Times Square. I know I'm running short on time, so I'll give the story quickly. I don't know, but it was real hot and for me. Me and my best friend, Dredd was his stage name. We're on our way from New York City back to Boston. The Port Authority bus terminal was where we were headed. The Port Authority bus terminal was, at the time, only a block away from the Virgin Megastore, which was in Times Square. God rest the soul of that fine establishment. I went into the Virgin Megastore because the next day Janet Jackson's Velvet Rope album was coming out, and I wanted to get some posters. See, back then, record stores would post, you know, would have posters in the window, but when the album was coming out, they would usually take the posters down and give them away. I went in the store specifically to ask somebody if I could get a Janet Jackson poster. The security guard told me, and I'll never forget, he said, nah, we're not taking them down. But, you know, as he said that, I began to walk away. And he said, but she'll be here tomorrow. I was like, yeah, I hear you. And but the thing is, I thought that what he was saying is the posters will be available tomorrow. So we walked out onto the sidewalk. I said to my friend, wait a minute, did he just say she'll be here tomorrow? My best friend says, yeah, I think so. It's too bad we're going back to Boston. I was like, yeah. So we turned around, went back in. I said, you said she'll be here tomorrow? Yeah, Janet's going to be doing an in-store autograph signing session, but you have to be one of the first 200 or 250 people, you know, online. I said, oh, okay.
I'm online.
The tickets were destroyed. The Greyhound bus tickets back to Boston were destroyed. And I went up to the Bronx to hang out with my buddy. And we came back to Times Square just in time to be somewhere in the 500s because people were lining up. Black luxury vehicle drives by the store. Somebody said, that's Janet. Whether or not it was, I still don't know. But half the line left and chased after that truck. My best friend said, yeah, we're going to go. I was like, no, we're not. Because even if she's in that truck, she ain't stopping. Stay your bleep here. We half the line left. I moved up. I got the tickets. I got to go meet Janet Jackson the next day. Sat in line for about 4 to 5 hours waiting to get my autograph with Miss Jackson. I had flowers for her. I gave her flowers. Her security said, we can't give her flowers. She said, yes, I want those flowers. Give me those flowers. Are those flowers from you, young man?
Oh,
and I said,
man.
So she says, what's your name? And I was like, and my best friend had to say his name is Kerry. And I was like, yeah, that's my name. That's my name. I'm sounding like her brother at this point. And all I remember is we took the picture. My buddy took the picture with a disposable camera because there were no cell phones back then. Mm-hmm. All I remember is saying to her, this is my dream in that voice. She said, oh, that's so sweet. Gave me a hug. So we went back to Boston. These are the days when you had to, you know, turn in your film to Walgreens and have them developed and all that other stuff. And so I had a friend that worked at Walgreens who, for a dollar, would develop everything in triplets. So I said to, I forget the Myron, these pictures are super important. Make sure you hurry up and develop them. He said, nah, I got you. He called me 10 minutes later. Your pictures are ready, but I hung up. They didn't want to hear what he said. I ran over to the Walgreens in Roxbury, and I said, Myron, why are all these pictures black? Is there something wrong with the machine? He said, I don't know, bro. I think whoever took your pictures had their thumb on the lens. That person would have been my best friend, Dredd. So I called Dredd, who lived several miles away in a suburb of Boston. I said, yo, the pictures are here, man. You got to come see him. When he got to my mother's house in Roxbury about an hour later, as soon as I opened the door, I caved his chest in. I didn't even say hello. I just swift one right to his chest. I took the wind right out of him. And to this day, I don't regret it.
I don't blame you. Honestly.
So, hopefully this May up in Mansfield, Massachusetts, I will get my second chance to meet Janet Jackson, as my mother and I are going to go to the show. We got VIP tickets, and it's So we'll see what happens. That's my long story. I know I'm way over. Way, way over. But at this point, pray for me, you guys, that I get to meet Janet Jackson. And I promise this time I'll keep the bass in my voice. This is your boy, Kerry D. Singleton. Kerry's Corner Radio Show. Let's get into these New Jack joints. Let's go.
Hey, yo, what's happening? This your boy, Five Mics. Anytime I'm looking for great entertainment or the latest scoop on the music industry, I pick up Intrigue Magazine. Because everything I read in it is so intriguing. Don't believe me? Then find out on your own. IntrigueMagazine.com, where reading is a pleasure.
And now it's time for those exclusive New Jack joints right here on Kerry's Corner, your new home for throwbacks and New Jacks.
Yo, what's going on in the USA?
Now, I don't know.
The womb wonderment of the U.S. government.
I'm sick of it.
Man, stay out my face.
You can never take my shine, because you know I work too hard, come too far. Why did you want to take both mine? But you can't, because I'm the queen of the hustle, queen of the hustle. If you want to come over here with me, I got money on my mind. I can't sleep, watch me eat. First thing on the agenda is protect my peace. Cause they're trying to take me back when I was black, when I ain't no better oppressed. But now I'm living at my best. I got so much I wanna get up off of my chest. Taking them away. Stand up and mean what you say. I got so much I wanna get up off of my chest.
Can't wait to use it, I swear, if a n- don't act right. With the-
day. Got a couple niggas coolin' for me. Coming from the south side. If it's water, then ready to shoot for me. You know how we gon' rock. Got a couple niggas on my head. Let's shoot the blow, we don't forget it. See the snakes in the grass and they wither. You cannot be in my picture. Huh? Shoot first, shoot back. My niggas don't care really who that. Run in your pocket, we know where the food at. We came up for nothing, my niggas said do that. If I zoom more, would you zoom back? Like Mario racing a two-track. I be the drop with your mood track. Fully loaded beam and I'm ready to do that. Tell me what you really waiting for. I got that iron on me. Run them, you get that with it on. Got a couple of looks that are right for the homie. Got a couple throwing dangerous. Keep that calling, no changing us. Came from the dredging, no taming us. That part of my life, I'ma aim the bus. Do you really wanna die today? I got shooters that shoot from a mile away. If it's problem, we stop it, no time to waste. When it's up, then it's stuck, either not a day. I got some shooters that's ready to kill. One phone call straight to the Ville. I call him Stacks and he ready to drill. I send a drop to the thot, make a deal. And I got some killers that's ready to pop. Put four to your head, make him drop. Brody, I'm going, you know you can't stop him. When you see him, you know he gon' drop him. I got too many problems. I'm going up and don't stop it. I'm on my way to the top. And me and my brother like Batman, he drop it.
I'm ready. every street. Oh, okay, we'll all be free. Imagine how pure this world could be.
As soon as I touch down, I tell them the king's here. They tell them to come now. I need everywhere. Cause if you pretty, I might get you some. They try and flex how I flex, so I flex on them. You see these sets on him, only shining but guess on him. They bring me all types I want, what you expect from him. New York, LA, Atlanta, Miami. I'm snatching every pretty girl, these can't stand me. And when we out in Perry, all they yelling is wee-wee. It's different overseas, they all be looking like Riri's. G, please, don't watch me, watch your TV. This a life you gotta see, if not, you wouldn't believe me.
Touchdown. I hit your phone, let you know where I'm at. Are you sliding right now? On the road, but for you, I'll take a break, yeah, yeah.
And we're back here on the Kerry's Corner Radio Show. You just heard from our New Jack segment. Started everything off with a sister that can really sing. Monique Nicole, she calls that one Queen of the Hustle. Followed up by Dreddy. Called that one Waiting For. We love that one here on the Kerry's Corner Radio Show. Ray Royale, our guest next week. He calls that one Not Ready. I don't think y'all are ready for him to be in the studio co-hosting with me. I know I'm not. God, he and I go way back, way back. So God only knows what he's going to be saying that he should not be saying. Melba Moore with the beautiful single Imagine from her latest release. And we ended everything off with Wanmore. Again, I don't know how to pronounce this. DJ Justin Simon, you're going to have to start giving me pronunciations. Wanmore. W-A-N-M-O-R. Featuring King Combs. And King Combs, of course, is Diddy's son. And that collabo was called Every Pretty Girl in the City. I actually like that one, which is not a big fan of Diddy or anything he's ever produced. But I guess the production of his son is not so bad. Shout out to King Combs. He actually follows me on Facebook, so that should be nice, right? All right. Brother I haven't seen in a while. Well, I saw him last week when he was here in the studio. And, of course, when we hung out at this dope, dope Yemeni restaurant that he introduced me to in Brooklyn, Yemeni Cafe. This brother is a award-winning film director. He's a filmmaker, a photographer, and he's a dancer, and he's a good dancer. And see, the thing is, I used to be a dancer, hence one of my infatuations with Miss Janet Jackson. So I'm very critical of dancers today. Most dancers today, in my opinion, you all look like you're like having seizures. I don't really get it. Like, it's just, it's not much like your fashion and music. I don't like it. But Aziz, I've seen his videos, and he's actually a pretty dope dancer. You can learn some things from him. Anyway, without any further delay, welcome to the show, my brother. How are you?
Hey, I'm pretty good, man. First of all, thank you very much, man, for having me. It's great to be here always,
man.
You're welcome.
It's great to have you here. And so you're not a stranger to the Kerry's Corner Radio Show. You've actually been a guest once before.
Yeah.
You were a guest a couple of years ago. I want to say 2019, 2020.
20. Yeah, 2020. Like that, yeah.
You were here with Quay Jones and Leo and Mike Tillman when we were promoting the Wanderers game video project from my Journey spoken word album project. That's where I first met you. So how did you get involved in that particular project?
Well, I know Quay and I know Leo. They're my friends. We always go and shoot, you know, films together and stuff like that, and commercials. So somehow we ended up, you know, like they're like, hey, Aziz, we need, you know, some assistance in cinematography and all that kind of stuff. And I'm like, yeah, man, for sure, yeah. And we met there. Yeah.
Yeah, we met at Leo's house. I remember a lot of guys. A lot of guys and ladies were there I think it was only one scene that I was. Yeah, I was only there for one scene of that particular short film that they did for my project. It was a lot of people. It was a lot of work. I was really impressed with the professionalism. All of you guys knew what you were doing. I felt like I was in a Spike Lee movie set or something like that. And it was pretty dope. Like, you and I exchanged information. And then you disappeared. Damn. We were working on more projects, the D20 Pictures guys and myself. And I was like, where's the guy with the dancing feet? Where's Aziz? Where's that guy? So what happened? Shortly after that film project, where did you disappear to?
Well, it's been amazing, actually. Suddenly I got a lot of projects on my line, you know. I worked on a couple of films with Quay and Leo also.
Okay, okay.
Most of them, shout out to Leo and Quay, they're like my closest friends,
yes,
you know.
Yes.
We always go shoot together. So yeah, I was like focused on films, commercials, you know, doing photo shoots, fashion photo shoots, you know. So I was deep diving, you know.
And I know that you love photography. One of the things that we talked about last week when we were having dinner at the Yemen Cafe is how much you love fashion. Kevon, you know I love fashion, right? Yeah, I'm being sarcastic. So there's a lot of fashion shows coming up next month here in New York City. Is Spring Fashion Week, I think that's what they call it. There's always this season behind or something. Yeah. So you were telling me that you love fashion shows. You love to shoot. By the way, I did send you an invite to a fashion show.
Oh yeah, I got
Did
that.
You get it?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
so yeah,
thanks,
as promised, I told you that I would invite you to all the fashion shows that we get invited to here on the Kerry's Corner Radio Show. Kevon, we get invited to some great shows. You think, right? Kevon, yeah.
Oh, yeah, every single show is well.
Well, yeah, except for that one.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, we won't even think about that one. But Aziz loves fashion shows, and he said to me, Kerry, if there's any fashion shows happening in the city, I want to come and film. And I was like, oh, you'll be pretty busy there, brother. Yeah.
New York City fashion shows go hard.
Yeah. So what about fashion shows do you like, Aziz?
Man, it's not just fashion shows. It's just the you know, the creativity in making a photo or like just shooting models, you know, commercials, all these kind of stuff. Like, this just drags me crazy, you know, because I feel like there's no limit in that, you know, in terms of photography and fashion photography. It's just the art of the fashion. You know?
Are you ready for the press pit, though? Have you ever been in a press pit at a fashion show?
No.
Okay, so
no.
Kevon, he's he doesn't know. So the press pit, Mr. Cox, of course, isn't here today. The press pit is when all the photographers get together in this pit, right? This group, and they're all vying to get the same shot. So it's like a whole bunch of bulldogs biting each other for the same shot. Are you sure you're ready? You're going to have to use some of your dancing feet and kick some of these guys. You're going to have to elbow them and, you know.
Like,
yeah, you just have to elbow them and get that shot. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, but yeah, it'll be fun. So you'll be seeing a lot of Kevon and myself at the fashion shows coming up in February here in New York City. So you're an award-winning film director. Talk to me about that. What? Because I know you got a Netflix thing going on, too.
Yes,
let's talk about that.
So it was, listen, so I did a couple of short films, all right? I did like over 5-6, you know, from day one, you know?
Okay.
And the last one, it got like recognized by film festivals. I submitted it
Excellent.
To a lot of film festivals. Yeah, thanks, man. And day by day, I started getting, you know, like accepted in a specific film festival. I got it into Hollywood Film Festival, New York Film Festival. It actually made it out to the finalists to the New York Film Festival in here. Yeah.
Dope.
So I went, you know, I wanted to expand my, you know, submissions and stuff. So I went internationally more.
Nice.
It got accepted in Ritzy Film Festival. It's one of the biggest film festivals in the Middle East.
In the Middle East, yeah.
Yeah, it got shown in movie theaters over there around Bahrain, Saudi, Dubai, all that kind of stuff.
So let me interrupt you. Yeah. Let me ask you a question. What was it like to see your film? And I asked Quay the same question.
Yeah.
What was it like to actually see something you created on the big screen in a theater?
Man,
that's a different experience.
That feeling is like, you know, you reach your maximum happiness.
Yeah,
you know, that you feel like, wow, all that hard work, all that grind, all that, you know, suffering to make that film happen, it just goes away, man.
Yeah.
You know, it just goes away. And when you see the audience watching your film, your work,
right,
it's a feeling you can't describe, you know.
Do you participate in the script writing for the films? Like, talk to me about one of the films that you got nominated for.
Yeah, so basically the film that I did, the last film that I did in it, which got on Netflix, I wrote it and directed it and acted in some parts.
Well, what's it called?
It's called Red Circle. You can watch it on Netflix right now.
What's the synopsis behind it?
So basically, it's about how people compare themselves nowadays, especially on social media. You know, once you scroll up Instagram, you automatically get anxiety, and you'll be like, "Oh wow, this guy's living the best life." This guy, even if you're living the best life that you have, you still have that feeling, you know,
of inadequacy.
Exactly. Yeah. And you'll be like, "Oh wow, they're having fun. What am I doing?" You know. So yeah.
Inadequacy. I don't know. Is that a
word? Wait.
I don't know. Like.
Yeah.
Feeling of inadequateness.
Yeah.
How about that? Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's talk about dancing. Right now, of course, we're listening to the lovely Janet Jackson. Like her or love her, you can't deny her being one of the queens of dance, particularly music videos. She made dancing in music videos a thing. Who are some of your favorite dancers?
Whew, that's a tough question. All right, I'm going to start with artists, okay? They're artists and dancers.
Okay.
First of all, we all know him, MJ, Michael Jackson.
Of course,
my idol. That's my number one, you know.
The late great. Yeah, and you're a serious moonwalker.
I try, man. I'm
well,
trying.
What you don't know is when this music goes off during our music break, we got to get some. Definitely.
Let's do it, man.
Get some music going.
All right.
Some dancing going. Yeah. Okay, so Michael Jackson.
Yeah, Michael Jackson, Chris Brown, two artists, man, like.
Not a fan, but I can't take away from the fact that he's a great dancer.
Yeah,
I just don't think he's a great anything else.
And the way he dances is so different than any other dancing, you know, a dancer. It's just like you feel like he has his own move. That's what I like about him, you know?
Moving next to the next person, please. Not a Chris Brown fan at all. All
right. No
Who worries. Else would you say that you look up to in terms of dance? Any choreographers? Any classic dancers?
Not really. No? There's a guy, he was called Ninja on social media. He's a pretty dope dancer. Okay. Yeah.
So in today, so obviously when I was a dancer, this was like in the early 90s. Late 80s.
Wait, you're a dancer? You never told me that.
I used to be a dancer.
Wow.
Clearly not anymore. I used to. That's the first thing I did in the music business.
Yeah.
I did a lot of choreography in Boston. Yeah, I had a dance group. But what kind of work does a dancer get nowadays? Because obviously when I was younger, our aspirations were to either be in music videos or to a lesser degree get shows on tours, which was hard because it was more about back then getting a gig as a dancer on a tour was based on who you know, not necessarily what you knew. So today, what kind of work, like what's the ceiling for a dancer? Like what's your aspiration to dance with Chris Brown? I would hope not.
I wish that. Chris Brown, if you're listening, man, I love you, man. You're the best.
He's not, believe me. But I'm just saying, like what is the ceiling for a dancer nowadays? Like,
well, it depends TikTok? On each dancer, you know? Nah, man.
I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, TikTok is cool. You know, some people make money out of it, a lot of money, but I don't know how. But anyways, so for me personally, I think like, if like you get on for example on stage with different artists
and you get
booked on commercials on you know some kind of events, mostly on specific events, you know, music events, all these kind of stuff, so that's maybe where I want to go, you know.
Okay.
It's more than that. Yeah.
So but you're so the thing, one of the reasons, I mean, you're a great guy. I love you to death.
Thank you, man. Aside from those things,
you're an international person.
Mm-hmm.
And so what is it like being from Saudi Arabia and breaking into the American culture? I know you spent a lot of time here, but being that you're originally from overseas, are you able to take some of the cultures maybe from the Middle East and interpret them into what you do here in the States? Like, how does that do?
Yeah, I mean, definitely, yes, of course. I have different experience from different places.
Right.
And here, it's not that hard to adapt for the culture and stuff like that, you know? As I told you before, I used to live here for like 3-4 years when I was like 7, something like that.
Right.
So it's like I can adapt. And it's pretty adapt to, you know, it's pretty easy to adapt to the culture here, especially like for me, a big fan of like MJ, movies, all that kind of stuff. Like I grew up watching all these kind of Americanized cultures, movies. And I'm like, yeah, it's not that hard.
But you also have the benefit of not being from here originally, right? And so are you able to use or utilize some of the cultures from the Middle East in your work?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah,
yes.
I think that would be really, really dope.
Yeah. Like my next film I'm shooting right here, it's Arabian / American at the same time. Yeah.
Dope.
So it's like mixed up, you know?
Right.
So it's, yeah.
Yeah, see, that's what I was saying. Like with the filming that you do and maybe even the dancing, you're able to consolidate not just American culture, but you know, Middle Eastern culture, you know, because you're proficient in both, and I think that's so dope. I want you to name for me as a dancer, doesn't matter who they are, I'll try to keep my comments to myself, but your top 5 songs to dance to. What 5 songs?
Ooh, that's a rough question.
Immediately gets you on the dance floor.
Damn. All right.
Number 1.
Questions by Chris Brown.
Number 2.
All right. Billie Jean's.
Number 3.
Smooth Criminal.
Number 4.
To My Bed by Chris Brown.
Number 5.
All right. Grass Ain't Greener, Chris Brown.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, at some point during the show, we're going to have to... We're not playing Chris Brown. But we'll find some Michael Jackson. We'll find some Michael Jackson songs. What were the Michael Jackson songs? You said Smooth Criminal.
Smooth Criminal, Billie Jean.
Billie Jean.
The Way You Make Me Feel. Oh,
okay.
Man, that's...
Okay,
that's,
so
that's
during your set, Dre, they can't hear you. You don't have a microphone. During your set, you're going to have to play something for him to dance to. We're not going to play Chris Brown because we don't play him on the show. But we have enough Michael Jackson to last a lifetime. And we're going to get Aziz on camera so that our listeners can watch on social media. How can people get in touch with you if they want to hire you as a filmmaker or as a photographer? I know you do wedding photography, right?
I've been doing weddings.
All kinds of stuff, yeah.
As long as it's art, yeah.
Right. Mm-hmm. If people want to hire you to direct a film or to do some photography or maybe even to dance at an event, what's your contact information?
Well, it's on my IG. Usually I'm always on my IG, Instagram. It's Aziz Sarhan 1. AzizSarhan 1. Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
What do you have? What's coming up? What's new on the horizon for my buddy Aziz?
Well, like I told you, I got my new film. I'm working on it right now. I'm actually casting people and seeing. You know, I'm gathering a crew and casting people.
Okay, so
to shoot it in New York.
Are you looking for people?
Yeah.
Let people know how they can reach out to you.
Yeah, exactly. You can. So far, you can reach me on my Instagram right now. It's Aziz Sarhan 1, yes. And we're looking for like over 10 actors. We literally just started yesterday, you know, started casting.
And what are you looking for specifically? Age, gender, height, what are you looking for?
Yeah, we're basically looking Arabians and Americans at the same time, so it's mixed. So for actors, we're looking for 4 males.
Okay.
And for females, we're looking for 3 females. Yes.
Age.
Exactly. Age around 25 to 30 and 35 to 40
They need to send you comp cards or
they can send me their headshots, you know, information about them, and we'll cast them, take it from there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, excellent information.
Definitely.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for being on the show, my brother.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, man. Appreciate you.
I look forward to making sure that you get into all of the fashion shows and all the good events that's happening here in NYC. I actually got to attend an event with the mayor, I think on the 20-something.
Oh,
so I'll let you know about that in case you want to come take pictures.
Yeah.
Without any further ado, let's get into our artist spotlight. Let's celebrate the music of Alicia Myers. She began her music career with the band Al Hudson and the Soul Partners, who, of course, later evolved into the group One Way. Alicia Myers went on to a moderately successful solo career in the early 1980s, scoring hits such as I Wanna Thank You, which was a mega hit for her, Don't Stop What You Do, and of course, You Get the Best From Me, a.k.a. Say. So without any further delay, we're going to let her say what she wants to say here on the Kerry's Corner Radio Show. Let's go.
What's up, y'all? Just kick back, relax, and listen to this week's Artist Spotlight. Shut up.
Now for my next number, I'd like to return to the
Hey, it's Mike Shannon, and you're listening to Club Classics on Kerry's Corner.
Get the point? Good. Let's dance.
Give it all you got. Rock, rock to the disco rock. Give
give it all you got. Rock, rock to the disco rock, give it all you got. Rock, rock to the disco rock, give it all you got. When you sing with sweet harmony, you are my lady, my fantasy.
ho if you got your funky bus fare. There's a double Dutch bus coming down the street, moving pretty fast, so kinda shuffle your feet. Get on the bus, pay your fare, then tell the driver that you're going to a double Dutch affair. D-5-4-4, well I be darned, here it comes. The double Dutch bus is on the street, you better get off the curb, move your feet. Bus fare, transpass, that's the way my money lasts. Ain't got no car to get around, when I go to work, I gotta go downtown. Now I miss my train, that's a darn shame, when I'm running late, no sleep's to blame. If you got a wife, you know I'm right, you got a special man, well I can understand. Uptown, downtown, everybody's getting down, say uptown, say downtown. Well, I miss my bus, I know I'm late, I gotta do something I know I hate. I'm gonna walk to work, 15 blocks, I already got a hole in my socks, go ahead and laugh. That's okay, cause what I really wanna say, I got bad feet, my coins hurt, top it off, I'm late for work. Let me tell you what I say when I'm dealing with a broken sidewalk. Let me show you how I walk when I gotta do my funky walk. Let me tell you what I say when I'm dealing with a broken sidewalk. I say, shh, sugar.
Hey, this is Kerry D. Singleton from the Kerry's Corner Radio Show, and you are in the mix with our DJ, Andre Jones.
Andre Jones. Suckers.
Thank you. anything in the world that I won't do. I'll give the world to you if you want me to. I'll do anything. Nothing in the world that I won't do. I'll give the world to you if you want me to. I'll do anything.
Andre Jones in the mix.
Love is real. Ain't no doubt about the way.
humming your back.
Time.
From the radio to the TV screen.